In the previous video, I wrote a PLC program that was able to energize the main and star contactors at the same time. I also have an on-delay timer here. When the star contactor is energized, this timer starts timing, and after 8 seconds, it will be active. When the timer is active, this open contact here will reset the star contactor. Okay, as you already know, the way that the Star-Delta starter should work is that when the start switch is pressed, both the main and star contactors will be energized at the same time. But after a few seconds, the star contactor should be de-energized and the delta contactor should be energized, all while the main contactor remains energized. This logic is able to energize both the main and star contactors at the same time, and after 8 seconds, it will de-energize the star contactor. So what I should do here is to figure out a way to energize the delta contactor when the star contactor is de-energized. For that, I will add a new network, and then add an SR flip-flop with the address of the delta contactor. I want the delta contactor to be energized at the same time the star contactor is de-energized. So what I'm going to do here is to add an open contact in the set input of this flip-flop with the address of the timer. By doing this, as soon as the timer is active, the star contactor is going to be de-energized in network 2. And then, in network 4, the delta contactor is going to be energized at the same time. Okay, so with this PLC program so far, by pressing the start switch, the main and the star contactors will be energized. And then, after an 8-second delay, the star contactor is going to be de-energized, and the delta contactor is going to be energized. The other thing that I need here is that I don't want the star and delta contactors to be energized at the same time. Why? Because the whole point of using a starter like this is to be able to run the motor with the star wiring connection and limit the inrush current when the motor starts, and then switch to the delta connection. Now, if these two contactors are energized simultaneously, they could crush the whole system. So to make sure that nothing like this can happen, I will simply add a closed contact with the address of the delta contactor in the set input of this flip-flop. And then, I will add another closed contact with the address of the star contactor in the set input of this flip-flop. With these closed contacts added, the star contactor will be energized only when the main contactor is energized, and the delta contactor is de-energized. On the other hand, the delta contactor will be energized when the timer is active, and the star contactor is de-energized. Okay, I also have a normally closed stop switch. As I already said, when this switch is pressed, I want the whole system to shut down. I've already added a closed contact for this switch in the reset input of the main contactor. So I'll go ahead and add two additional closed contacts in the reset input of the star and the delta contactors as well. By adding these closed contacts, when the stop switch is pressed, all three contactors are going to be de-energized at the same time. And that's how the whole system stops. I will also add another closed contact for the timer so that I can reset the timer when this switch is pressed. Now, I've got a question for you. Do you remember why the stop switch we're using in your control system should be normally closed? If you do, go ahead right now. Yes, right now, and explain it in the comments below this video. This will help you remember this forever, and also helps other electrical and automation engineers just like you to learn the benefit of having a normally closed stop switch when designing control systems. And if you don't remember that, you may want to watch part 10 of this video series again. I explain this at the end of that video. Okay, the program is now complete. If you have any questions or comments, please go ahead and put it in the comment section below this video. Now, let's move on to the next lesson and download the PLC program to the simulator to be able to test the logic and see if it works as expected. Many of you have expressed that this is the easiest lesson learning environment that you've come across. We've heard many of you expressing how much you're enjoying this content. If this is your position, please communicate your appreciation of our videos with a like. The more likes we get, the more enthusiastic we are to continue to provide this content in the future. So show us your love now and like this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already done so. That way, each new video will be sent to you as it's published. In addition to the likes and subscribes, make sure that you head over to RealPars.com to find even more training material for all of your PLC programming needs. We offer many videos to assist you in learning PLC programming and landing that job in the high-paying, highly sought-after field of automation and controls engineering. Go to RealPars.com and subscribe to our highly effective training series now. Your future awaits.